Aspeges me. Misericordiam tuam. Domine exaudi orationem meam. Dominus obiscum. Oremus, ex animos Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens et Eterne Deus, et mitere digneis sanctum angelum tuum de celis. Vicus odiat foveat prodigat visitat eque defendat omnes habitantes nunc habitaculo per Christum Dominum nostrum. Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In primo d'altare Dei. Judicam et Deus edicione causa meam de gentemum sancta. Avni in coloroso erue me. Emiter ucem tuam et veritatem tuam et semet ad adoxerunt in mortem sanctum tuum et in tabernacula tua. Confite voti vincita, Deus, Deus, meus patricis est anima mea, et voi conturbas me. Gloria Patri et Filio Spiritui Sancto. Entro ibo ad altare Dei. Adito nostrum in nomine Domini. Confite ad omnipotenti, Beate Maria, Sempre Virgini, Beato Michele Arcangelo, Beato Iani Battiste, Sanctis Apostolis, Petro, Paul, Omnibus, Sanctis, Oistratres, Pia Pecavini, Mesu, Jesus, Fini, Verbo, et Opere, Mea Culpa, Mea Culpa.
culpa, mea maxima culpa, ideo pecor beta meriem sape virginem beatum, vicinem arcangelum beatum, ionem batistam, sanctus apostolus, fretum et palme, sanctus os fratres, orare pro mea dominium Deum nostrum. Amen.
Miserato vestra omnipotenza, sede missis peccatis vestris, pedagat vos, vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam, solutionem et remissionem peccator nostrorum. Tribuat nomis omnipotens et misericors dominus. Deus te conversus, vivificabis nos. Hostane nomis domine, misericordiam tuam. Domine exadiat finem meam. Dominus obiscum. Oremus.
Yeah.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. Et in terra pax omnibus humanibus et apostolibus nostris et dominus in omnibus. Gratias agimus tibi pro te manem gloria pro omnia Deus sex in excelsis. Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine Filii unigenite Iesu Christi, Domine Deus et Deus Filius Patris, Petulis peccata mundi misere nobis Petulis peccata mundi sanctus peccata nostra. Presidens exterra Patris misere nobis coniam tu solus sanctus, o solus Dominus, o solus altissimus Iesu Christi. Pro Sancto Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen.
Glorificamus
presumus Domine, du ut et mundi cursus pacifice nobis, tu ordine dirigatu, et ecclesia tua tranquilla devotione letetu, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convite treniat vitat espiritus sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Lectio epistolae beati Pauli apostoli ad Romanos. Fratres existimo quod non sunt condigne passione suius temporis, ad futuram gloriam quae revelabitur in nobis. Nam expectatio creaturae revelationem filiorum Dei expectat. Vanitate enim creatura subjecta est, non volens et propterium qui subicit citeam in spe, quia et ipsa creatura liberabitura servitute corruptionis, in libertatem gloriae filiorum Dei. Scimus enim quod omnis creatura ingemiscit, et parturitus quae aduc. Non solum mater minacet et nos ipsi primitia spiritus habentes, Edifici intra nos gemimus, adoptionem filium di expectantes, redemptionem corpus nostri in Christo Jesu, Domino nostro.
Propitius est Domini peccatis nostris et nequandum dicamus gentes vies Deus eorum. Adiuva nos Deus, habitaris nostri et propter nos honorem nominis tui Domini, libera nos. Alleluia, alleluia, Deus Christe super solum et unica sepultatem. Est refugium populum in tribulatione. Alleluia.
Oh.
Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam. In illo tempore contubei ruerunt erruerent in Iesum. Ut odiret verbum Dei et ipse stabat secustarium genes daret. Et vidit duas naves tantes secum stagnum, piscatores otem ascenderont et lavabant eretia. Ascendens otem in unam navim quae erat Simonis, rogavit eum a terra reducere post illum. Et sedens docebat de navicula turbas. Uce sabitotem loqui dixitat Simonem, doc in altum et laxate retia vestra in capturam. Et respondens Simons dixit illi, Preceptor, per totam noctem laborantes nic incipimus, in verbo etem tu laxaborete. Et cum hoc fecissent concluserunt piscium multitudinem, copiosam, rompebatur otem rete eorum. Et annuerunt socis qui erunt in alia navi, et ut venirent et adiuvarent eos. Et venerunt et impleverunt ambas naviculas, ita ut pene emergerentur. Quod cum videret Simon Petrus procedit ad Genua Iesu dicens, exia me quia homo peccator sum, Domine. Stupor enim circumdederat eum et omnes qui cum illo erant, in captura piscium quam sceperant, similiter otem Iacumem et Ioannem filios Zebedei, qui erant socii Simonis. Et aetat Simonem Iesus, noli timere ex hoc iam homines eris capiens, et subductis a terram navibus redictis omnibus, secutis sunt eum.
Reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Romans for the fourth Sunday after Pentecost. Brethren, I reckon that the sufferings of this time are not worthy to be compared with the glory to come that shall be revealed in us. For the expectation of the creature waiteth for the revelation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him that made it subject in hope. Because the creature also itself shall be delivered from the servitude of corruption into the liberty of the glory of the children of God. For we know that every creature groaneth and travaileth in pain, even till now. And not only it, but ourselves also, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption of the sons of God, the redemption of our body in Christ Jesus our Lord. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. At that time, when the multitude pressed upon Jesus to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Genezareth. And he saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them, and were washing their nets. And going up into one of the ships that was Simon's, he desired him to draw back a little from the land. And sitting, he taught the multitude out of the ship. Now, when he had ceased to speak, he said to Simon, "Launch out into the deep, and draw, and let down your nets for a draught." And Simon answering said to him, "Master, we have labored all the night and have taken nothing, but at thy word I will let down the net." And when they had done this, they enclosed a very great multitude of fishes, and their net broke. And they beckoned to their partners that were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they were almost sinking. And when Simon Peter saw, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." For he was wholly astonished, and all that were with him, at the draught of fishes which they had taken. And so were also James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were Simon's partners. And Jesus said to Simon, "Fear not, from henceforth thou shalt catch men." And having brought their ships to land, leaving all things, they followed him. The announcements of the week. We have a week only with two masses because the other two priests are preaching the retreat. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, the two masses at 7 and 11:25 a.m. And Monday is the feast of Saint Elizabeth. And Wednesday, the seven holy brothers martyr. On Thursday, two masses, 7 a.m. and 6 p.m. with all day adoration in between. On Friday, St. John Gualbert, two masses, 7 and 11:25 a.m. And Saturday, one mass at 8 a.m. Next Sunday, the fifth Sunday after Pentecost. So, please, we ask you to pray for the repose of the soul of Mrs. Gemma Demafelis, that is the mother of Brother Bart. She passed away on Friday, so please pray for the repose of her soul. Also, this week is the next week is the week of the retreats, the men retreats. The retreat starts at 1 p.m., but at 11:30 a.m. there will be a mass celebrated on site. If you want to attend the Mass, let Mrs. Tangela know so that you may have a lunch prepared for you afterwards. This is also the 2 weeks of vacation, so I do exhort the students to be busy with the Bagathon fundraising for the school. They should go and see your neighbors and your friends to fund the prize for the school and make a good impression, a good model of what the school is by a good example. Otherwise, the usual meetings and prayers, prayers on Tuesday for in reparation, holy adoration on Thursday with the holy hour for priests, especially at 11:30. And the inquiry meeting tonight at 6:30, the adult catechism on Tuesday at 7 p.m., and the Legion of Mary tonight at 4 p.m., and Wednesday at 7 p.m. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Reverend Father, Dear sisters, my dear brethren, on the Feast of the Sacred Heart and on the previous Sunday, and the next Sunday, you meditated on priestly vocations because of the ordination at Icon and Salzkofen. And today also in the Gospel we have the vocation of Peter and the first four apostles, Peter, James, Andrew and John. But I would like to speak today a little bit more about the other vocations, that is, vocations of brothers and sisters to the religious life, that is, to the perfection of the Christian life by the practice of the evangelical councils. You are blessed in this parish to have two brothers and many sisters for your edification, and you need to pray for them and for vocations. And to understand the importance of that life. Why do they renounce the world? Why do they choose for God? Because they found a better thing. You see, it is like a pearl of great price hidden in a field, and those who find it, they go, they give all whatever they have, and they buy that field. They find a better thing. You see, the inner life, the spiritual life, is the most important life. Indeed, what is human life? If you ask St. James says in his epistle, "For what is your life? A vapor which appeareth a little while and afterwards shall vanish away." In other words, it's very little. Our human life is very little. If you look at the life of your body, what is a human body? So small, it's so fragile, the least bug can put down quite a few people, like it happened in the past few weeks. What is a human body? So little. You see, and we are born, we grow, we work hard, and we die. That's pretty much the life of the body. And that's not very enthusiastic at all. Some people who are materialistic, they don't think there is anything else, they try to rush up to enjoy this life as much as they can, and they are not really happy with it anyway, and then they miss. Now there is also the interior life, the life of the soul, and that is much more important, much more beautiful. And those who discover the value of that life, that's why they renounce the world, in order to live the true life, that is the interior life. And to understand the relation between both, just consider what is more important. Take an example, and I take a very simple example that is plain to everyone, and it's an example of a big sin, like killing. Killing is a big sin. Everybody agrees, you know, thou shalt not kill. Killing is wrong. And suppose someone, you know, takes a gun and kills his neighbor because he hates his neighbor. Now, you have the act of the body, which takes a gun and press the trigger. But unless there was inside, in your soul, a decision to do so, either a positive decision, you know, cold blood murder, you know, or at least a negative decision, that is, let the anger or the hatred take over and, you know, follow the passions instead of being the master of yourself, your finger would never have done so. So what is more important? Is it the external moving of the finger, or is it the interior choice to kill your neighbor? Which one is the cause of the other? Which one is responsible? No, the one who is the cause of the other, the one that moves the other, the one that is, you know, the motive and the leader, is the internal choice. It is the internal choice. That is the one responsible. Now you might say, but if the finger had not moved, the neighbor would not have died. That's true. But to the external evil deed, you are liable to the human court. But do you think that to the internal deed, you are not liable to any court? You are. And if you are prevented to do the evil deed because you don't have a gun or whatever, you know, but you still have the hatred in your soul, you are still guilty in the internal court. That is, in the court of God. But who can know what you have inside? God sees everything. The light of God shines all over and pierces through and through all our mind. God knows everything. We cannot hide anything to Him. In His light, all our choices are very clear. They can be good choices or bad choices. And the life of our soul is precisely this list of choices that we do day after day. Do we choose for God, or do we just disregard God and choose for self to do whatever we want? I don't want anybody to tell me what to do. How many people say that? Oh, I don't like that, I won't do it. About Latin, how often do I hear some children say, I don't want to study Latin, you know. But this is a choice of which God is witness. Does he approve? You will have to render an account of all your choices. What you choose has consequences. And why is it so? Why is it so? Because every choice is the affirmation of a certain principle. If someone kills his neighbor and chooses to kill his neighbor, the choice itself is the affirmation that the commandments of God, I can disregard them. And that is a lie. No one can disregard the commandments of God with impunity. God is God, and God is not mocked. St. Augustine put it in a very simple way. He says, either you do what God commands, and you shall be rewarded according to the law of God, or you do not what God commands, and you shall be punished still according to the law of God. Both ways, you cannot escape. So what do you prefer? That choice is yours, yes. Do you prefer to be rewarded according to the law of God for having done what God commands? Or do you prefer to be punished according to the law of God for not having done what God commands? But you can't escape the law of God. God is God, and who are we to rebel against God? So, what we choose is the affirmation of a principle. If we live for God, if we choose for God, we affirm the truth. We reaffirm that God is worthy to be obeyed, and that goodness must be chosen. You see, we live the truth. We profess the truth by our life. St. Paul says we do the truth in charity. So when we choose for God, out of love for God, we do the truth in charity, we build up a solid interior life. But on the contrary, when we choose to follow our own will, or when we disregard, you know, the law of God, and we say, oh, anyway, there is no God, I don't care, we live a lie. We affirm a lie, and we deny the truth. We imitate in that sense the devil, who is the father of lies, and who is a liar from the beginning. And we live in darkness, because lie is darkness. See? Our Lord is the light that came into the world, and men have loved darkness rather than the light, our Lord says. He who does evil does not come to the light, lest his evil deeds be manifest. Like Adam. You remember Adam, you know, when he got sin, he hid himself. Why did he hide himself? He said, because I was naked. Not so much physically, but spiritually. He had lost the wedding garment, that is sanctifying grace, which is required in the nuptial, the feast that is prepared by the king for the marriage of his son. You see, those who are invited to the wedding feast must have on the wedding garment. Adam had lost it by sin. He hid, but did he escape the sight of God? God found him. God found him. He did not escape. You know, he hid the light, he lost the light, you see. If one dies in that state of sin, then the veil is torn, the veil of the senses, because many people live outside of themselves. They don't listen to the interior life. They live outside of themselves. And they live in sensible things and forget about the spiritual things. But at death, that veil is torn off. And the list of their choices, that is the spiritual life from the beginning, that list appears in the light of God, and they are judged by that. You know, like the spotlights are turned on, and the man is found spiritually naked, you see. And with great shame, he throws himself into hell. That's what happens to those who don't live in the state of grace. But on the contrary, if you are... St. Paul says, you know, you were once darkness before your conversion, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk then as the children of light. That is, and the fruit of light is in all goodness and justice and truth. We choose that which is good, you choose that which is just, You choose that which is true. You choose to do your duty, whether you like it or not, emotionally, but according to your mind, that is the light of your mind, you choose to do that which is objectively good, that which is objectively according to the light of God. Approving that which is pleasing to God. And then St. Paul continues, and don't associate yourselves with the barren works of darkness, the worldly things, you know, the fruitless works of darkness, which is done. And then he says, what is done by them in darkness, it is shameful even to say it. The modern world gives us so many examples of that. You know, the works of darkness, people hide themselves to watch all kind of dirty stuff, you know, because it's shameful to see it. So that God sees it. God sees everything. And the choices that you made, one day will appear in that light of God. And what will you say? If you would die now, if the light would be made on your own soul, where would you be? So St. Paul says, get up, you who are sleeping, and rise from the dead, that is, rise from sin, by a true conversion, you know, and Christ shall illuminate you. Then you shall have the light of our Lord. And confession, St. Augustine says, is the first step in doing the truth. Acknowledging and with contrition the wicked life past is the first step in doing the truth. Living the truth. Doing the truth in charity. So remember that the external life is very little. Our body is very little. It's so fragile, it's so useless in many ways. The important life is the interior life. The choices that you make. You choose for God, or you choose to disregard God. And at the end of your life, you will be judged on that list of choices that you have done. So live in the light of God, which no one can escape. The truth is the truth. And we have to live according to the truth, but we can't change it. And that is the choice. You know, those who have understood that divine light that shines in the darkness. And as St. John says in his gospel at the very beginning, we have it at the end of every Mass. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In him was life, eternal life, and life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and darkness did not comprehend him. That is sin. He was the true light, who illuminates all men. In his light we can see, coming into this world, but the world received him not. But to those that received him, he gave power to become sons of God, children of God. Those who have understood that value, to become children of God by living in the light of the Son of God, living in the light of Christ, you know, then they are willing to give up the world to find that pearl of great price. That is this beginning of eternal life, to live in the light of God here below, so that we may live forever in the light of God. And not only should we live ourselves in the light of God, but as the Blessed Virgin Mary, to reflect the divine light for others. Our Lady is called Maristella, the star of the sea, Ave Maristella, Hail the star of the sea, because she reflects the light of the sun. Our Lord is like the sun of justice, which is reflected by the brightest star, which is Venus. It reflects the light of the sun, and that makes the star beautiful. You know, and it also guides us. So we should also, in our turn, reflect the light so that we guide others on the path of holiness and virtue, following Our Lady and all the saints to heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Edo in unum Deo. Patrem omnipotentem, factorem scelieti, revisionem in spesivis, et in adam Deus in personam filiorum in plenitum, et ex patre natum ad omnia secula, Deum de Deorum et de Lumine Deum, Deum de Deo vivo, genitum non factum vosum sonde, patri per comunia facta sum, qui propter nos amines et propter nostram salutem, descendi de sinis, et incarna tus et spiritus. Crucifixus est iam pronovi sub pontius Pilatus, passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit ex terti alias et lumen scripturas, Attachez les jeunes chers, c'est d'être extra-rapatrie, c'est l'idée de l'être, vous êtes mon gloria. Je dis que la vie vous êtes mort, 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 vous êtes Orate Patres, Omnipotentem, Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Sursum corda. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro. Dire dignum et justum est, cum et salutare. Nos tibi semper ubique gratias agere. Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterne Deus, qui cum unigenito Filio Tuo et Spiritus Sanctus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in uniu singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate substantiae. Quod in imne tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de Filio tuo, hoc de Spiritus Sancto, sine differentia discretionis sentimus. Ut in confessione vere sempiterne quae deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in majestate adoretur equalitas. Quam laudant angeli atque arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, in ancesum clamare quotidie, una voce dicentes.
Sanctus, 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 Domine Deus, Abbate, nec concede per gloria tua, Dominus Christus, benedictus tu, Domine mei, Dominus Amen.
Sit down. Abisque peccatoribus. Omnia secula seculorum. Confirmus preceptis salutaribus ammoniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Agnus Dei cotoris peccata mundi miseria nobis. Agnus Dei cotoris peccata mundi miseria nobis. Agnus Dei cotoris peccata mundi da nobis pace. Tu Gesù Cristo che hai visto questo visto e spazio nel tuo socio. Sappi di me che hai detto un po' secondo me che hai detto 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 che hai Et vacuum et tous sempre venire mandati se te non passi per l'eternità su di me. Non sempre se te non sempre se Gesù Cristo. Quote con ogni Dios mare preso mona di te con la tua missione di te semen. Per tua tua pietà di apposi me che non te la tua vita di te. Che se te ne esponde a te non te la sposa di Dios con la sua vita. Adesso resti ma ci prima. Domine nostrum dimis in Christi et nunc et in hora Domine nostrum dimis in Christi et nunc et in hora Miserato vos omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris per grat vos vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam solutiam et remissionem peccatorum vestorum, tribuet vobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Et cernus et secutorit peccata mundi. Domine non subninius in tres ductum meum, set ant unic verbo et snabitur anima mea. Domine non subninius in tres ductum meum, set ant unic verbo et snabitur anima mea. Domine non subninius in tres ductum meum, set ant unic verbo et snabitur anima mea.
Refugio meu, meu liberator meu, seu Deus meu, seu Deus meu.
Dominus vobiscum. Oremus, mysteria nos Domine, quae sumus sum ta purificent, et sum onere tue ontur, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, filium tuum, qui te cum et et regnat vita te spiritus sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Dominus vobiscum. In sum sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum, operat in principio apud Deum. Omnia per istum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum est, nihil quod factum est. In ipso vita erat, et vita erat, lux minum et lux sunt, et nebis sunt, et nebis comprehenderunt. Quintum omnis sus ad equo nomen erat Ioannes. Sic unit in te est omnium, te est omnium per ibere de lumine, ut omnes crederent per illum. Non erat ille lux, et ut te est omnium per ibere de lumine. Erat lux vera quae illuminat omnem homine evidentem in mundum. In mundo erat et mundus per ipsum factus est et mundus non conivit. In propria venite sum non receperunt. Quod totem receperunt eum, et et eis potestatem filios Dei fieri, isque credunt in nomine eius, filan ex omnibus neque ex vontate carnis neque ex viris ex Deo natis sunt, et verbum caro factum est habita viti nobis, et vidimus gloriam eius gloriam quasi unigenitia Patre, tenum gratia et veritatis. Salve Regina,
Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes nostra salve, A te clamamus, Exules filii,
respiramus, gementes et frentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego advocata nostra, illos tuus misericordes oculos, a nos converte. Et Iesum benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, o pia, o Amen. Thank you very much.
Well.